We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Nightmask, Issue 1. This is from 1986, from Marvel Comics' New Universe imprint. Written and created by Archie Goodwin. Penciler and co-creator was Tony Salmons. Inker was Bret Blevins. Letters by Joe Rosen. Colorist Andy Yanchus. Editor Michael Higgins. Editor-in-chief Jim Shooter. So there's a kid named Keith Remsen. He is in a coma when the White Event happens. It's a bizarre astronomical event that somehow grants people paranormal powers, and he has a fragment of metal wedged in his skull, which is what resulted in his coma, apparently. And his sister Teddy is in a wheelchair. We get a flashback as to what happened. A terrorist left a bomb near his family. It exploded, killed their parents, left Teddy crippled, and almost killed Keith as well. And he's got this moon-shaped scar on his forehead, and it turns out the White Event gave him the ability to enter other people's dreams. And he uses this ability to track down his parents' killer, and it also ties him to his sister. She's able to bring him out of other people's dreams. It's pretty interesting. Their parents were psychiatrists or psychologists, one of the two or both, I don't know. But we have an interesting cast of characters. We have one of their parents' friends, who's this black doctor, and this lady, Lydia, who's apparently the physical therapist for the sister, Teddy, or Theodora. Now, unfortunately, Lita speaks in Spanglish, in that Dora, the explorer, Spanglish, where certain words are in Spanish for no apparent reason, even though they make zero sense being in Spanish. So that's kind of annoying. Overall, it's an interesting origin story. There's a lot more talking than I expected, but it's plot-driven. This isn't a character that's going to be easily wedged into an action book. It's much more of a character-driven story. And he comes up with the costume and everything. He enters this guy's dream to find out who the killer is, and he has to interpret the dream to figure out what's going on and who this person really is. It's actually a pretty cool concept. Some of the dialogue is a little dated. He calls his sister Squirt, which was more of an 80s thing than it is today. And there's a few other minor instances. Some of the dialogue and stuff's a little wonky, but other than that, it was a pretty fun book. I didn't feel ripped off from the $2 I paid for it. It has a 75-cent cover price. I easily would have felt comfortable paying $2, $2.50 for it, maybe even $3. It's a more cohesive story than a modern Marvel comic, and it's much better written and much better drawn. So I enjoyed this one. I'm going to recommend it. It's not going to be for everyone, but it's a fun, complete story, and it's a all-around good book. So I had no issue with it, other than a few minor little things that are more of an effect of age, and the weird Spanglish thing just annoys me in general. So otherwise, it was a fun comic. I would definitely recommend this if you get a chance to pick it up. Pass over that garbage new Marvel book that you know is going to be drawn terribly and written with all sorts of goofy stuff in it, and go for some vintage Marvel instead. I think you'll enjoy this one a lot better than the majority of the modern stuff, but that's just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.